Arizona News Radio, former Maricopa County Sheriff Joe Arpaio, campaigning for Jeff Flake's U.S. Senate seat, tells a Republican women's group in Scottsdale he sympathizes with families separated at the U.S. border. But then he jokes that President Trump stole his tent city idea.
Why did you ask me about DACA? Why did you ask me about the kids that are being incarcerated in tents? They even steal my tent program.
Meanwhile, a new poll shows Congresswoman Martha McSally leading in the Senate race, with Kelly Ward second and Arpaio third. State Republican lawmaker Noel Campbell says David Stringer's recent comments that there aren't enough white kids to go around wasn't artful, but Stringer is not a racist. Stringer's come under criticism for those comments. Wells Fargo relocating 91 jobs from its San Francisco headquarters to Chandler. Wells Fargo is already Arizona's fifth largest employer. Geico weather, sunny and hot statewide the next 2 days. Jeff Munn, Arizona News Radio.
This KFNX traffic report has been brought to you by Compassion International. There are stop-and-go traffic off the Loop 202 between 32nd Street. Slow traffic in Tempe off the Loop 101 southbound on Rio Salado Parkway. Also, slow traffic in downtown Phoenix on I-10 westbound. Food, water, education, and more is what you'll give to a child in poverty. Release a child from poverty at compassion.org.
From the KFNX Weatherbug Weather Center, as we head into the evening, we're under an air quality alert. It'll be clear tonight, overnight low 81. Thursday, sunny and hot, high 110. We have an excessive heat warning from tomorrow morning at 10 through Friday night at 9. I'm Scott Allen Fortney from the KFNX Weatherbug Weather Center.
Currently, in downtown Phoenix, it's 106 degrees.
Next news in 30 minutes or when it breaks, here on Independent Talk, 1100 KFNX.
I love my family, but last week, not so much. They blew through our shared data again. Then we switched to Boost and got unlimited gigs, plus 20 gigs of mobile hotspot on each line for the whole family. For a great price. So now I love them all again. We just needed a switch.
Switch to Boost and get 3 lines with unlimited gigs for just $100 a month and 20 gigs of mobile hotspot on each line. Plus, get up to 3 free phones, all on a super reliable, super fast nationwide network. Boost makes it easy to switch. Switching makes it easy to save.
Offer ends 8/31/18. First line is $100 a month. Lines 2 and 3 are $0 a month. Requires 1 line to port in. Line includes unlimited talk, text, and data. Video streams optimized at up to 480p+. Music at up to 500 kilobits per second. Gaming at up to 2 megabits per second. Data deprioritization during congestion. 3 phones require port in and activation on plans $50 or higher. Covered in offers not available everywhere. Restrictions apply. See dealer for details.
The information and opinions you hear on this radio show are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and do not necessarily reflect the opinions of KFNX, its affiliates, management, or advertisers.
Live from the Midtown studios of KFNX, it's time for the Wellness Roundtable Radio Show, sponsored by Atrix.com. Now, here's your hosts, Dr. Spear and Dr. White.
Here in Phoenix every Wednesday on 1100 Independent Talk, KFNX, from 3 to 4 in the afternoon. I'm Dr. Spear, along with my co-host, Dr. Scott Weiss, from New York City. Dr. Weiss, how are we today?
Dave, I had a really special day after I spoke with you.
And let's hear it.
I got a chance to share some space and hang out with the notorious MMA Conor McGregor.
Wow, really? Did you know that that was going to happen when after we spoke this morning?
You know, of course we hear things that are going on, but you don't know, you know, what's exactly going down. So, you know, I've known from experience, you know, not to talk about things until it really happens.
Sure,
and,
sure.
And we had a feeling he was going to be coming into the clinic out in Southampton, and he did, and he ended up coming in. And not only did he come in to really, so to say, rent out the place and really practice rolling, but he got a full workout in, and it was great to share space and see what we're going to talk about soon. Another father training at his peak. But boy, it was a treat to share space and time with Conor McGregor.
That's amazing. And how old is he?
You know, I don't know offhand. I'd say he's definitely in his 30s, early 30s.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not sure. But I know he's been a dad for about a year or two, if I'm not mistaken. And, you know, what a really relaxed, cool guy, That boy did a little bit of jiu-jitsu, did a little bit of striking. You know, he didn't stay for too much rehab, but he did some foam rolling. But it was really good to see his methods and how he kind of becomes the best at anything and becomes the champ. Again, it's a really treat to share space and time with him.
That's amazing. And you know, talking about sort of becoming a champ, there's a the huge part of that is the mental attitude. Obviously, he has the physical attributes, but also you need that mental toughness, especially in the sport that he's involved in.
He came from really humble backgrounds, Dave.
Uh-huh.
You know, I mean, I think he was on food stamps at one point, you know, so it's really incredible to see somebody rise to the top like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, that's great. That's a great story. And so today's show is really going to be spent kind of in honor of Father's Day that just passed. And, you know, Scott and I were kind of discussing over the weekend what topic would we like to talk about, you know, during this show. And we both kind of came up with the idea of fitness for dads. And as fitness has become really a, you know, multi-billion dollar business, there are many different directions to go here. However, I think, you and I just want to keep it simple today and just kind of, you know, maybe a few take home messages for dads at different stages in their fatherhood. So maybe, you know, we should start with a new father and then kind of end with, you know, fathers that are older that have children that may be out of the house, maybe, you know, have graduated college or have their own jobs or whatever, but their children may be self-sufficient and therefore what do they do? Right. So let's kind of, you know, we'll get personal first and we'll talk about ourselves and then we can talk about, you know, how that kind of, how that integrates with fathers at different points in their lifetime.
It's a great start.
Okay.
Totally. And me and you are at really opposite poles as we've, you know, chatted about and laughed about.
Correct.
Many times.
Right. So, yeah. So when it comes to children, you're a new dad and I'm maybe not an old dad, but more of a middle of the road dad. I have a son who's 12 and a daughter who is 15. And so, you know, yes, they're self-sufficient, but also they don't drive yet. They're not independent in that way. So there's still things that I need to be able to be there for them to get to the places they need to go, get to their activities and things of that nature. So for me, you know, I feel like I would tell dads in my situation, and of course it's all obviously individual. It depends upon the working situation, it depends upon a living situation and all of that. But I do think that there is time during the day to focus on health and fitness. And we're not necessarily going to talk about nutrition as much as we're going to talk about fitness. But there are several ways I think that one can go about, becoming fit if someone's in, let's say, my stage, right? And I think one of the things that you may want to look toward is there's the option of joining a facility, which really kind of takes a little bit of the guesswork out of things, right? That means, you know, either, hooking up with a personal trainer or a coach. That's a possibility, or just joining a facility, on your own and then doing things on your own using other types of resources, whether it be books or videos, which I don't highly, highly recommend, especially for people who are not necessarily used to, following a fitness program. But I do think that when you join a facility, you offer a lot of the kind of the amenities and the additions to your fitness program that you wouldn't get if you were doing it on your own. And that includes equipment. It includes socialization. It includes also technology. I mean, a lot of the places that are popping up around here use very advanced technology to record heart rate and, you know, determine where you are in terms of your workout level or your exertion level. So there's a lot of that. And I think that that's an easy way to kind of get involved, right?
I would say, Dave, to sum what you are saying up is that you at that point have the time. When your kids are kind of at that age, it's not like you have total freedom and flexibility like they're in college, but you're on the path to that. So you do have the time to join up for a class or a course or work with someone personally. You know, and on the other pole, I'm with them nonstop. They're not in school yet.
Right.
So there's a whole nother, you know, focus on the dad when your kids are under four.
Right. Absolutely. They're constantly moving, which also makes you constantly move too. And in very sort of ingenious and inventive ways, you can use that movement to your advantage.
I agree. And that's what's key. So as you can take a course or really have the time to go to, you know, join a gym or get a trainer.
Sure.
Of course I can do that and, you know, put the kids with a babysitter. But I'm talking about, you know, at this age, you know, for a child and for a dad, you know, when you're really doing a lot with a kid, you have to kind of move right. So like you said, exactly, they're moving a lot, so you move a lot. But if you move improperly, you heighten your chance of injury with shoulders, with your low back, you know, with your posture so intensely. So I think like one of the key points that I'm focusing on when you're at the, you know, four age and under.
Right.
I mean, you're dealing with car seats and feedings,
yep.
Is you have to move right. You have to have the right posture because you're going to be adding loads to that posture, which is that 35-pound-year-old kid. So you have to really move right and do it together with your child versus having the true freedom of just taking a class, which
right.
I don't at this point.
And you make a good point. You have to do it together with your child and not sort of in opposition to. And let's talk about that in the second segment. Talk to me about, as a new dad, how you use mechanics in the right way, especially when you're dealing with, you know, situations where you may be in an awkward position, like taking out a car seat or like, you know, picking up something, you know, even picking up your child, things like that. Let's talk about those mechanics to make sure that that take home message really gets conveyed. That's an important one.
Let's go down that path.
Yeah. So Dr. Weiss and I are talking about fitness for dads in honor of Father's Day just last week. And we'll be right back with the Wellness Roundtable Radio Show on Independent Talk 1100 KFNX.
Speak to an expert? Have a question involving your health and fitness? Visit wellnessroundtable.com and listen to the Wellness Roundtable Radio Hour right here on Independent Talk 1100 KFNX every Wednesday at 3 p.m.
Information on better health, fitness, and nutrition is everywhere, but much of it is about selling and not teaching. Jerry Branham's Applied Metabolics newsletter is different. No ads, no advertisers, only pure, unvarnished truth. Jerry Branham has written for bodybuilding magazines for over 35 years and published over 6,500 articles. And has been on the scene of fitness and nutrition for 56 years. His Applied Metabolics newsletter is an incredible source of practical, no-nonsense guidance, offering in-depth information about nutrition, food supplements, exercise science, ergogenic aids, anti-aging and longevity research, women's health issues, fat loss techniques, preventative medicine, and more. For only $10 a month, that's less than a cup of coffee per day. Subscribe to Jerry Branham's informational and transformational newsletter and get information to guide you on the path toward health, longevity, and overall well-being. Visit AppliedMetabolics.com. That's AppliedMetabolics.com.
Matrix is one of the fastest growing companies in the footwear industry and is widely recognized as a global leader in comfort and wellness footwear products. The Matrix mission is to create the healthiest shoe on the market today. With fashion, function, and quality at the forefront, Matrix designs and manufactures most types of footwear for both men and women. All styles are crafted with care to meet the highest standards in design, incorporate cutting edge technologies, and offer unmatched customization and adjustability. To learn how Matrix can help you with your feet, go to AETREX.com. That's Matrix.com.
Are you tired of traveling or waiting to see a health professional? Now you don't have to. Video chat with an expert anytime, anywhere, and get your health questions answered. Visit wellnessroundtable.com and speak to experts from all over the country in the areas of health, wellness, and fitness. Wellnessroundtable.com offers an on-demand system that allows you to connect to an expert immediately. No scheduling, no appointments necessary. Wellnessroundtable.com. Visit our website and take advantage of our on-demand system, wellnessroundtable.com, where you get your questions answered. Wellnessroundtable.com.
Come join Aging 2.0 for the annual Optimize Conference in San Francisco on November 14th and 15th. With 1,000-plus attendees each year, this is one of the largest conferences in the field of aging. It is an annual conference with cutting-edge content, networking, and partnership opportunities that make this a high-value event for anyone interested in innovation and aging. This year, it is taking place in the iconic Herbst Theater at the War Memorial Building in San Francisco. Optimize will feature captivating keynotes, exclusive networking opportunities, unique market insights, and a cutting-edge showcase of innovative exhibitors. Get registered today at www.aging2.com/optimize-2018.
Back with the Wellness Roundtable Radio Show, and we're talking about fitness for dads or fitness for fathers, however you want to put it. And Dr. Weiss and I have been talking about fitness for dads, but as dads kind of age with their children, how does the fitness change? So we're going to start kind of at the beginning, as Dr. Weiss is sort of a new dad. So what are the ways, Scott, that you kind of deal with fitness on your end of things, and how do you use body mechanics in the correct way so that you don't necessarily injure yourself?
Well, I'm not perfect at it, Dave. You know, I got to admit, is that, you know, everybody's in training. I mean, I don't care if you're the best athlete in the world. You're always conscious of it, and no one does it perfect. But I'm trying to be as best and as conscious as I can about if I have to lift them up to make sure that I keep my back in a neutral position, which means not too flexed forward, not too far extended, or not bent forward or backwards. You try to find the middle ground and function in that realm, which really is the best for the body biomechanically. So if I squat, I'd make sure my, you know, to pick a child up, I make sure my knees don't go over my toes. I make sure that my hips are and my low back are sitting backwards. I bring the child as close as I can to me, meaning like I shorten the length of the lever arm, if you will, kind of like the hammer. Like I pull the hammer closer to me. So anytime I really lift and I move with them, I try to make sure that my hips, my low back, and my shoulders are in a good position so I prevent any overextension or, you know, really, so to say, injury pattern.
Right. And when you're holding them, do you suggest holding them on your hip or do you hold them kind of closer to your chest when you hold them?
That's a great question. There are so many devices out there that can accentuate and help you hold a child on your hip. You put this little strap on your back. There's a little, almost say, saddle to your right. Or if you're a lefty, you put it to the left. You can put the kid right in there, and you're good. Those are great. I do agree with things like that. But I like using the muscles of your body the right way, almost like you're doing a mini workout. So I try to make sure that I'm not on one hip kind of hanging on my ligaments. I don't like that. I don't like putting the kids up on the prop of my bone, so to say.
Right.
So I like using the muscle in the correct biomechanical position, which I was trying to explain a little bit before and is a whole other topic. But if you're doing that and really putting yourself in the right mechanics, your muscles are using the right amount of force and enduring it while you're holding the child, that's the best for your body.
Got it. So now what about devices like a baby Bjorn or devices like a backpack? Would you suggest that a child, and especially, you know, a small enough child to fit into one of those devices, is on the front or the back?
It really depends on the person's body shape and their somatotyping, we usually refer to. So there are people that can carry a child in a sling. You know, like if you take some of the, you know, anthropological, you know, African children and the mothers, I mean, they hold children not only on their head but on their sides of their body, but it's slung in the proper method.
Right.
And they switch it. It's not for the same position for a long period of time. You have to, if it's on your right hip, you have to switch it to the left. When they walk very long distances, it's not about the same position forever. So I think understanding the fact that if you're sitting for a long time, you got to change your position. If you're driving for a long time, change your position.
For sure.
And really with kids, it's doing the same thing.
Yeah, I think that's a really good point. And also, you know, with young kids, and I remember when my kids were small, is that there are situations where you can be put in an awkward position. You know, you may bend down quickly to, let's say, stop a kid from falling or something like that, but you do it kind of unconsciously, and then those biomechanical tenets go out the window, right?
Yeah.
So you end up, you know, in a way, your mechanics are now improper, and then that's when you can actually injure yourself, and that happens. But if you're conscious, I think this is a really good point, because we've really stressed this throughout this show, since we've had this show, which is you have to be conscious. You have to be fully aware of your mechanics, fully aware of what type of activity you're doing and how it's actually helping you function or how it's affecting specific muscle groups. Also, you have to be aware of posture. We've talked about that, you know, ad nauseum on this show.
Dave, I agree in a way, that's why there's accidents in life, you know, and things just happen. So the idea is when you train properly and you move with your child properly all the time, when you have to do those far, not normal reaches, you'll be okay.
Right.
That's the point.
Right.
I think that's the takeaway, is that by you doing the right training and doing it in multiple angles and stressing the system prior, that when it happens and the, you know, the unconditional thing happens, you're able to adapt to it and you don't get injured.
Yeah.
That's the key takeaway, I think.
Yeah, and you know, you make a really good point, because the training involves specific exercises. I was doing some research before the show, and one of the most recommended exercises is the squat. And we talked about that. We had an entire show on that last week. Which for some people it might be boring, and it's like, oh, why are these guys talking about this? But honestly, I mean, it's like it could be the king of all exercises, because you involve so many different muscle groups. Not only that, but you're totally self-aware of posture. And when you're picking up small kids or, you know, working with smaller children, that is a absolute key exercise. It's a key movement to be able to do correctly.
Yeah, it's like a clean and jerk.
Right. Right. So, but then there's something else that kind of comes up, which is flexibility. And, you know, we're talking about sort of strengthening, right, as having a child who's a younger child. What about flexibility? You need flexibility as well, because you need to be able to make those, right, you need to be able to make those movements and like we said, and kind of reduce the likelihood of injury.
Yeah, that's first. If you don't have, so to say, the path and the range, you'll never, you can't build anything on that. So like the guy that walks down the path and takes the machete and cuts the leaves, now you have a path for something to grow on and
right.
do whatever you want. But if you don't have the range or the flexibility, like people talk of their back, you know what I mean? If you want to strengthen your back for posture, but if you don't do the doorway stretch and have flexibility in your chest,
like we talked about, right,
you will never get good back strength.
Right.
So flexibility becomes first. Range of motion is first. Strength usually slowly follows.
So now we're talking about having younger kids. And obviously, you know, younger kids are not necessarily aware of the type of movement that they're doing and how it affects you, how it affects your function. They just kind of run around. Right? So you have to chase them and you have to pick them up and you have to, you know, there's a lot of different movement to that. And you can watch any mother or any father with young children and you'll see very interesting movement and biomechanics. As kids get older, their arbitrary movement slows down a little bit and their movement becomes more deliberate, whether it be walking, running, whatever that is. And as a father, you know, having, let's say, I don't want to say, maybe toddlers to sort of, you know, 7, 8-year-old children, you find that they can then mimic your movement. So if you can become, as a dad, a role model, right? So you can show them kind of the right way to move. Although you might even argue that babies move in a way that is so sort of innocently pure that it's correct, right? Like when they squat.
Like we can learn from them almost. Right. Like we should be learning
that's
from
exactly
them.
Right. Like, that's exactly right. Like you could emulate their movement because their movement is so pure. But as children get older, you now start to, as a dad, you know, again, you have kids who may have activities, extracurricular, whatever they're doing. Now you could start to actually work with them. And what do you think about that?
I mean, I do that right now. You know, like my kids take jujitsu. You know, so it's funny when you can actually bring them to a class and let the instructor do their own thing. I think that's really, really important. But then when you get home, you have to reinforce it.
Sure.
And by doing those things with them is just, you know, further ingraining their neuromuscular growth, their reach between their brain muscle. It's just ideal. I think we know that training as a young kid makes the inroads, so to say, in your brain so deep. You know, you do the same martial art, you do the same sport from 3 years old to 25. It is the movements are natural, like you said. So,
absolutely.
Yeah, I think there's sometimes we could emulate what they're doing, but there are definitely times where we can direct our kids.
Yeah, I agree. And when we come back, we'll talk a little bit more about that sort of that neuromuscular portion, the neuromuscular facilitation that we find in kids and how that works. We're here on the Wellness Roundtable Radio Show. I'm Dr. David Spearer along with Dr. Scott Weiss on Independent Talk 1100 KFNX. We'll be right back.
Common Sense, Independent Talk, 1100 KFNX, the true voice of Arizona. Independent Talk, 1100 KFNX.
President Trump signed an executive order to keep migrant families together at the southern border, but said his zero-tolerance policy remains. Republican Senator Tom Cotton says there are some significant challenges to address.
We cannot allow a child to be a get-out-of-jail-free card and a get-into-the-U.S.-free ticket. But at the same time, as you said, as we've all said, we'd like to keep families together, keep them together at the border for the orderly and timely processing of the adult's immigration claim.
A Justice Department official says it will ask a federal court judge to modify a court settlement and allow authorities to detain illegal immigrant families together for more than 20 days. The limit now is 20 days. An Ohio man who tried to recruit members for the Islamic State has been sentenced to 16 years in federal prison. Amir Saeed Rahman Raghazi, formerly Robert McCollum, pleaded guilty in March of 2016. I'm Barbara Cusack.
Here is your KFNX traffic report brought to you by Unbound.org. There's stop-and-go traffic on the Phoenix Loop 202 westbound on 32nd Street. Stop-and-go traffic on downtown Phoenix I-10 westbound between Loop 202. You can be the difference between a child continuing their dream of an education or leaving it behind. Help them make their future brighter one child at a time at unbound.org.
From the KFNX Weatherbug Weather Center, as we head into the evening, we're under an air quality alert. It'll be clear tonight, overnight low 81. Thursday, sunny and hot, high 110. We have an excessive heat warning from tomorrow morning at 10 through Friday night at 9. I'm Scott Allen Fortney from the KFNX Weatherbug Weather Center.
Currently, in downtown Phoenix, it's 107 degrees.
Next news in 30 minutes or when it breaks, here on Independent Talk, 1100 KFNX.
Want to speak to an expert? Have a question involving your health and fitness? Visit wellnessroundtable.com and listen to the Wellness Roundtable Radio Hour right here on Independent Talk 1100 KFNX every Wednesday at 3 p.m.
information on better health, fitness, and nutrition is everywhere, but much of it is about selling and not teaching. Jerry Branham's Applied Metabolics newsletter is different. No ads, no advertisers, only pure, unvarnished truth. Jerry Branham has written for bodybuilding magazines for over 35 years and published over 6,500 articles and has been on the scene of fitness and nutrition for 56 years. His Applied Metabolics newsletter is an incredible source of practical, no-nonsense guidance, offering in-depth information about nutrition, food supplements, exercise science, ergogenic aids, anti-aging and longevity research, women's health issues, fat loss techniques, preventative medicine, and more. For only $10 a month, that's less than a cup of coffee per day. Subscribe to Jerry Branham's informational and transformational newsletter and get information to guide you on the path toward health, longevity, and overall well-being. Visit AppliedMetabolics.com. That's AppliedMetabolics.com.
Come join Aging 2.0 for the annual Optimize Conference in San Francisco on November 14th and 15th. With 1,000-plus attendees each year, this is one of the largest conferences in the field of aging. It is an annual conference with cutting-edge content, networking, and partnership opportunities that make this a high-value event for anyone interested in innovation and aging. This year, it is taking place in the iconic Herbst Theater at the War Memorial Building in San Francisco. Optimize will feature captivating keynotes, exclusive networking opportunities, unique market insights, and a cutting-edge showcase of innovative exhibitors. Get registered today at www.aging2.com/optimize-2018.
Matrix is one of the fastest growing companies in the footwear industry and is widely recognized as a global leader in comfort and wellness footwear products. The Matrix mission is to create the healthiest shoe on the market today. With fashion, function, and quality at the forefront, Matrix designs and manufactures most types of footwear for both men and women. All styles are crafted with care to meet the highest standards in design, incorporate cutting edge technologies, and offer unmatched customization and adjustability. To learn how Matrix can help you with your feet, go to AETREX.com. That's Matrix.com.
Are you tired of traveling or waiting to see a health professional? Now you don't have to. Video chat with an expert anytime, anywhere, and get your health questions answered. Visit wellnessroundtable.com and speak to experts from all over the country in the areas of health, wellness, and fitness. Wellnessroundtable.com offers an on-demand system that allows you to connect to an expert immediately. No scheduling, no appointments necessary. Wellnessroundtable.com. Visit our website and take advantage of our on-demand system, wellnessroundtable.com, where you get your questions answered. Wellnessroundtable.com.
We're back with the Wellness Roundtable Radio Show on Independent Talk 1100 KFNX, and we're talking fitness for dads. Give us a call at 602-277-5369 to join in on the conversation or ask a question, or toll free at 1-866-536-1100. So, Dr. Weiss, we've been covering a little bit about exercise in terms of dads with younger kids, and you made a nice point, which was that younger kids really develop kind of a second nature ability when it comes to activities or really anything. And what we really need to kind of identify is why that is, right? So from a physiologic standpoint, the nerves in the nervous system are continuously growing. However, usually between ages 2 and 3, you start to get basically a slowing of that growth, or the synapses or the connections that are being made. And also, there's something called the myelin sheath around the nerves, which acts as a sort of, if you would think about wiring in a house, acts as kind of the insulation.
Yeah, wiring the cable.
Of the nerve wiring. Right. So the more myelin, the faster the messages. And then when you take somebody who, or a child who has started a sport at the age of 2 or 3, by the time they're 5 or 6, the, those patterns are now ingrained in that nervous system. Whether that be guitar, whatever it is, hockey, basketball, it doesn't matter. You take that same kid and start them at the age of 6, and you probably get about 75% of what you would have gotten at the age of 3. And then as they get older, it's that much harder. That's why for adults, for most adults, it's difficult to pick up kind of a new activity. How would you tell dads to sort of reconcile that? Knowing that, your child is developing so rapidly in terms of their nervous system and their ability to pick up new activities, new movements. How can a dad kind of use that to their advantage?
You know, Dave, it's like a great question, but it's about time. I feel like, you know, for like at least myself in like the new dad situation, as you would say, you know, under four, you have to take the time and teach them those techniques. It has to be something that is not just done by like, oh, I brought the kid to the class. I brought the kid to, you know, the teacher. It has to be reinforced at home.
Yeah.
You know, like when I take the kids to jiu-jitsu, it's great when they go to Sensei Greg. They love Sensei Greg and everything is great. But when I go home, I'm like, I'm going to get you in a leg lock. Tell me what you're going to do. You know, and she's like, oh, you know.
Right.
And you have to kind of reinforce that. And then, you know, and then sometimes my son will say, no, Dad, I don't want to play jiu-jitsu right now. You know what I mean? And they're not in the mood. So you really kind of, you can't force anything.
Right.
You kind of got to go with nature naturally is usually what I say.
Yeah, it's a balance. And I think that's a really good point of reinforcing it, because you could take even the smallest kids to a Gymboree class or Mommy and Me class or whatever. And that's great when they're there. But you're right. If it's not reinforced, it's like practice or like anything else. They won't be able to, you know, they won't excel at that particular activity. When it comes to older dads, dads of kids who are elementary school age, you know, especially in a suburban area of the country, there's a lot of driving involved. You're always in the car, whether you're taking them to school or taking them to activities or whatever it is, or even driving back and forth to work. Dr. Weiss, you have some sound on the other end there. Okay, it's clear. And, you know, when you're in the car, you really start to get stiff, especially after, you know, you've been driving a while. So my thought is, and what I've been doing as a dad of elementary school kids and also now high school kids, is a lot of flexibility exercises. And that could be anything from a simple sort of toe touch to some yoga poses to, you know, things like, double knee to chest, single knee to chest kind of things. And I have found that that's really helped, because I spend probably about 60 to 65% of my time in the car. That was never the case when I lived out east. So I think that that is something that dads need to be very cognizant of, and they need to sort of practice those kinds of flexibility exercises to keep the lower back limber, to keep the hamstrings flexible. That very, very important, because the next time you bend down to pick something up, now your back hurts and it's because you have tight hamstrings. You even mentioned something to that effect in the first segment. And in looking at some of the exercises to do, along with the squat, came the stiff leg deadlift.
Dave, you know, I'm going to stop you even before that, because I really relate to that. I'm putting so many miles on my car with my drives that I go back and forth sometimes 2.5 hours, 2 and 3 times a week, 6 hours back and forth. So what I'm realizing is that I'm pretty flexible. You know, not only was I done Tang Soo Do for so many years and, you know, have a yoga certification, I'm realizing that when you're driving, you have to do the opposite movements then. Something's got to be combative at that time. It's not good enough to say, oh, I just drove for 3 hours, I got to go stretch right now.
Right.
I don't think that's really how the body totally and truly adapts. It's doing it. You cannot sit for that 2.5, 3 hours. So, I mean, I don't know if it's because of my height, which is, you know, definitely a little vertically challenged, but I'm able to, at 5'6", extend my legs in my car while I'm driving, and I don't recommend this to everybody.
It's like texting while driving, stretching while driving.
Yeah, I thrust my hips forward, extend my back, and then sit down. And I try to do that at least every 20 minutes. I use that, like, you know, the tomato effect. So I think that the key is not doing it after and trying to be preventative. That all helps. But if you're not doing it at the time and you're just doing the posture for so long, that's the problem. So that you have to interrupt the posture is what I'm saying.
Right. Now, I think that's a great point, and I think another way to do that would be to pull over and spend 5 minutes just stretching and then get back in the car.
That's what those truck drivers have the time to do. If we can do that and adopt that, you're right. It would be great.
Right, because then it takes away the sort of the safety issue of doing it while you're, you know. But if you can do it, if you're on an open highway or something like that and you can do that, that's great. You probably wouldn't do it in city traffic because you wouldn't have that, you know, that ability.
No, but
to do
I
it.
Do. Sometimes if I'm in city traffic or I'm at a light, I could do it.
At a light, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, a light. I could do a spinal twist to the left.
Yeah.
And that's what I'm saying. You got to be conscious.
Absolutely.
You know, you do whatever you can do with the safety in mind.
Absolutely. I agree. So as a dad of elementary school kids and high school kids, as Dr. Weiss was saying before, you know, you could join a facility, get a coach or a personal trainer. That's a possibility. But there are some really basic exercises that I think would be really helpful. And those are the squat, the deadlift. But with the deadlift, you have to make sure that you're doing it correctly. The other two, I would say, are pull-ups and push-ups. And we can talk a little bit when we come back about body weight exercises and how those really affect not only the musculature but also function. And as Dr. Weiss had mentioned before, flexibility is paramount, really, really important. So when we come back, we're going to talk a little bit more about older dads. And like those dads that might be in their 50s and 60s and what they do for fitness as well. So we're talking about Father's Day fitness, kind of belated, on Independent Talk 1100 KFNX. This is the Wellness Roundtable Radio Show with Dr. David Spear and Dr. Scott Weiss. We'll be right back.
Tired of traveling or waiting to see a health professional? Now you don't have to. Video chat with an expert anytime, anywhere, and get your health questions answered. Visit wellnessroundtable.com and speak to experts from all over the country in the areas of health, wellness, and fitness. Wellnessroundtable.com offers an on-demand system that allows you to connect to an expert immediately. No scheduling, no appointments necessary. Wellnessroundtable.com. Visit our website and take advantage of our on-demand system, wellnessroundtable.com, where you get your questions answered. Wellnessroundtable.com.
Want to speak to an expert? Have a question involving your health and fitness? Visit wellnessroundtable.com and listen to the Wellness Roundtable Radio Hour right here on Independent Talk 1100 KFNX every Wednesday at 3 p.m.
Information on better health, fitness, and nutrition is everywhere, but much of it is about selling and not teaching. Jerry Branham's Applied Metabolics newsletter is different. No ads, no advertisers, only pure, unvarnished truth. Jerry Branham has written for bodybuilding magazines for over 35 years and published over 6,500 articles and has been on the scene of fitness and nutrition for 56 years. His Applied Metabolics newsletter is an incredible source of practical, no-nonsense guidance, offering in-depth information about nutrition, food supplements, exercise science, ergogenic aids, anti-aging and longevity research, women's health issues, fat loss techniques, preventative medicine, and more. For only $10 a month, that's less than a cup of coffee per day. Subscribe to Jerry Branham's informational and transformational newsletter and get information to guide you on the path toward health, longevity, and overall well-being. Visit AppliedMetabolics.com. That's AppliedMetabolics.com.
Come join Aging 2.0 for the annual Optimized Conference in San Francisco on November 14th and 15th. With 1,000-plus attendees each year, this is one of the largest conferences in the field of aging. It is an annual conference with cutting-edge content, networking, and partnership opportunities that make this a high-value event for anyone interested in innovation and aging. This year, it is taking place in the iconic Herbst Theater at the War Memorial Building in San Francisco. Optimized will feature captivating keynotes, exclusive networking opportunities, unique market insights, and a cutting-edge showcase of innovative exhibitors. Get registered today at www.aging2.com/optimize-2018.
Matrix is one of the fastest growing companies in the footwear industry and is widely recognized as a global leader in comfort and wellness footwear products. The Matrix mission is to create the healthiest shoe on the market today with fashion, function, and quality at the forefront. Matrix designs and manufactures most types of footwear for both men and women. All styles are crafted with care to meet the highest standards in design, incorporate cutting edge technologies, and offer unmatched customization and adjustability. To learn how Matrix can help you with your feet, go to AETREX.com. That's Matrix.com.
Back with the Wellness Roundtable Radio Show on 1100 KFNX, and we're talking about Father's Day fitness. Give us a call at 602-277-5369 or 1-866-536-1100. So, Scott, we were just talking, I was just kind of finishing up talking about some, you know, basic exercises that one can do. And we had mentioned squats, we'd mentioned deadlifts, to be done, obviously, with the proper mechanics. Also, push-ups and pull-ups have been sort of rated as those body weight exercises that, you know, that many, many individuals can do in various ways. You can do it modified if you want to on a wall. You could do it on your knees. You could do a regular push-up, as we know a push-up to be. But these are exercises that I think are very helpful for the muscles that we use, you know, all the time, for functional muscles. The thing is that as we get older, you know, we tend to lose the levels of testosterone and our muscle strength tends to decline. We know that from, you know, physiological text that it usually happens after the age of 25. So how do we maintain that strength? Now you're not lifting babies, you know, you're not lifting children. You're not really chasing children around unless you're, you know, playing one-on-one basketball with, you know, your child. But now it becomes really a conscious effort to be able to kind of keep yourself in shape. So what do you say to those guys who are a lot older who want to stay in shape but, you know, maybe just don't know how to start?
Dave, first off, I know that, you know, as you age, it's really, really hard to keep your lean mass on.
Right.
Period. So you have to go out of the way and lift weights. That's it. You know, if you want to maintain a little bit more faster of a metabolism and to really strengthen your body, you want to carry a little bit more mass. You have to strength train as we age. So that's
right.
The first thing.
Yeah, I agree, because I think, you know, that those forces that are placed on the muscle and bone are, you know, those weight-bearing forces are extremely important to keeping them strong. Okay.
Right, but to preface that, as I was saying earlier, flexibility is the prime thing. You know, really practicing flexibility, you know, whatever form it is really longevity for the joints and the muscles.
Right.
And
for sure.
And that's important. So you have you create your path with your range of motion, then you build your strength, then that's ideal. And then just keeping the right mechanics of what you're doing is final, like the final movement. You know, if you can relearn things or reeducate your body if need be. If those like childhood instincts don't kick in naturally and you have to retrain yourself, that's important to do along the way. But yeah, the flexibility is important to make sure your strength is important. And then of course, you know, you cannot neglect your cardiovascular system at all.
That was the question. Yeah.
Or I would say the cardiorespiratory system.
Yeah.
Like saying it better like that, because it is the heart and lungs, you know, and you need to create bigger space, bigger breath, bigger stretching of your costal cartilage and your intercostal muscles. You need that as well as adapting to the metabolism and the metabolic rate.
Yeah, so to kind of maybe not play devil's advocate, but to tell you sort of what's out there on the internet,
sure,
is that, you know, when you're focused on, you know, six-pack abs as a dad, you really shouldn't care about the cardiovascular exercise. And I just think that's a wrong thing to say. I don't believe that, you know, eliminating cardiovascular exercise is the way to gain more strength. That's never been shown. But also, it's essential. I mean, as you know, right? It is absolutely essential to maintain at least a modicum of aerobic capacity. You don't have to be able to, like, sprint up hills, but you need to at least have a heart and lung that can, heart and lungs that can function efficiently.
Yeah, cardiorespiratory fitness not only dictates your heart and lungs, it really dictates and translates to every organ of the body.
Correct. It's circulation. Yeah.
That's the difference.
That's
you know what I mean? So I think people have to realize that you can do all the muscular strength you want and the flexibility you want, and you're going to do great for a few systems. But if you don't work and balance out your training, you'll miss the other systems. And that's exactly, so to say, without being too blunt, the wrong thing to do.
Yeah.
It must be balanced
out. For sure. And especially, you know, when you talk about it from sort of a physiological perspective, when you're talking about strength and muscles and you know, flexibility and sort of the nutrients that go to those muscles, right, that kind of are really important for the function, the strength of those muscles, now you're dealing with the oxygen, right? So you have to get the oxygen to those muscles. And one of the ways to do that is through cardiovascular training. And that makes for a more efficient system, you know, overall. I mean, you know, heart rate goes down and your recovery comes up and you get more nutrients to the muscles that you're working in a more efficient manner. So I don't agree with the whole idea of throwing. I think you're throwing out the baby with the bathwater if you're throwing out the cardiovascular.
Well, but
training.
You know, Dave, me and you are thinking truly from like a scientific standpoint. You know, without a major goal, and we're talking about universal health.
Right.
That's where we're coming
from.
That's
right. Exactly.
I think you know, like when I work with a celebrity that needs to gain weight for a movie role.
Yeah.
You know, as Stu does, it's not about everything. Sometimes the shift is more towards nutrition and gaining weight.
Correct. Right.
You know, so, and then if you're doing bodybuilding and it's a couple days before, it's about losing water weight and making the skin really thin.
Correct.
So you can be veiny. So, you know, it depends. We're talking about a universal general health, but there are people that work on specifics, you know?
Right. And I think, that point is kind of how we started the show, which is there's an individualization to training. Of course there is. They have different goals and, you know, we have different body types and we react differently to different exercises. That being said, this is more of a blanket statement that these are sort of the three major areas that need to be, you know, kind of addressed, right? So flexibility, strength, and cardiovascular function or cardiorespiratory function.
And not to add too many things, but I think that there are like passive things like, you know, good sleep,
yeah,
you know, for really good health.
Absolutely. Yep.
You know, things like that are just really, really
right.
Just so important to add to the variable.
Right. And that's not specific to fathers. I mean, that's for everybody. But when we're talking about dad fitness and kind of to sort of, you know, sum up what we were talking about, when you're a dad with younger kids, you really got to focus on the biomechanics of picking up your kids, of, you know, running around with your kids. You got to be conscious of your posture. You got to be self-aware of your body.
And sleep when they sleep.
That's a great point. And sleep when they sleep. Also, there are times during the day where you might be able to even do a little bit of exercise, right? You know, whether that be when you're waiting for something to heat up in a microwave, if you're, you know, maybe you have something in the oven, you have an extra 5 minutes, whatever it is, waiting for the computer to go on or whatever. There are little pieces of time during the day where you can use that to your advantage. If you're a dad of kids who are elementary school age or even high school age, as I am, I think then you could sort of start to play with them in a different way. Biomechanics are not necessarily what you really want to focus on every day, although very, very important. You should still be self-aware of your posture. But now you can actually do the activities with them in a way where it's a little bit more reciprocal. And, you know, some of those activities that have been really touted as being so important are squats, deadlifts, push-ups, pull-ups, things that are kind of your basic activities, basic exercises. And if you're an older dad, then, you know, you really need to focus on kind of the idea that you're losing strength as you age and that you really need to focus on weight training, as you mentioned. Flexibility is paramount and cardiorespiratory function is also extremely important to help get oxygen and blood flow to those working muscles to help them function and make them more efficient and keep them healthier. And I think those are the major take-home messages.
Yeah, I mean, I would agree. And, you know, it's great that people are becoming a dad, and the dads that already a dad
right.
are amazing. And
right.
everybody just got to realize there is time to exercise. There is a space. You just got to really want to do it. And sometimes it's not about just going to the gym. It's finding a sport you like, finding an exercise, an instrument you like, because everybody's an athlete.
Absolutely. I think that's a great way to end it. So we've been talking about Father's Day fitness here on the Wellness Roundtable Radio Show on Independent Talk 1100 KFNX. I'm Dr. David Spear, and for my co-host, Dr. Scott Weiss, we are out of here, and we'll see you next week.
What more can I say? What's left to provide?
Been listening to the Wellness Roundtable Radio Show right here on Independent Talk 1100 KFNX. Tune in next week for more from the experts on the Wellness Roundtable Radio Show.
The information and opinions you hear on this radio show are those of the host, guests, and callers, and do not necessarily reflect the opinions of KFNX, its affiliates, management, or advertisers.
Matrix is one of the fastest growing companies in the footwear industry and is widely recognized as a global leader in comfort and wellness footwear products. The Matrix mission is to create the healthiest shoe on the market today with fashion, function, and quality at the forefront. Matrix designs.
We really ought to get the patriots of this country, not just the motorcycle clubs and people that, you know, still believe in the Second Amendment, private property, but the veterans who've been targeted by the Democrats, by the globalists. I mean, we've got the reports, I've shown them on air, where DHS domestic terror warning, where they said that we stand by veterans being the number one terror threat in America with no evidence, no metrics, no nothing.
Alex Jones, nights 1 to 4 a.m., Independent Talk, 1100 KFNX. You're listening to Independent Talk, 1100 KFNX, Cave Creek, Phoenix. A division of Premier Radio Stations, the home of Laura Ingraham, weekdays 6 to 9 a.m. It's 4 o'clock.